What's going on, everybody? Jem Mint back again with another statue unboxing and review. This time we have Casca from the Golden Age arc from the Prime 1 Studio Berserk line. You guys know I'm a huge fan of Berserk and I've been waiting on this piece for a while. I'm going to do an unboxing, I'll do an assembly, I'll give you my final thoughts, and then I'll leave you with where I have her in the collection. So with that being said, let's jump into it. All right, we're going to start with the bottom of the box because of that little compartment. But first, it does come with some bonuses. You have a little 2022 QD1 calendar. So this is pretty cool to have. I might actually use this at my desk or something. So it's got all the different characters on the side. It also comes with an advertisement for Batman the Merciless, the 1/3 scale from Dark Knight's Metal. And on the reverse side, Batman the Drowning from the same line, same scale. So that's the advertisement. Then it does have the package contents for Casca, and on the reverse side of this is the assembly guide, which it looks like we're gonna need. There are a ton of pieces in this. So like I said, that bottom compartment there, that has the Band of the Hawk flag. The only mixed media piece, I guess you would say, the only fabric piece that does have wires in it. Very tough, sturdy, like canvas type of fabric. And we're gonna put a spear through this to go on the back of the base. All right, on the top of the box, there's a compartment on top as well. So removing that, you can see there are a ton of pieces here. Let's remove all the paper here and start taking a look at these pieces one at a time. A ton of swords though, as you can see. All right, first, we have a couple of different feathers. Some of them go on some of the enemy's helmets and some of them go on Casca's helmet. So very well done. They're white with a hint of blue. The sculpt is great. I love how it looks with a bunch of them clumped together. Here we have a left arm for Casca, so you can see the great leather texture and the brown, the nice folds and wrinkles of the fabric. You even have those bronze buttons around like the bottom there. Here we have an arrow and a bloody axe. The axe looks good, a lot of dings in it. Good wood effect here. And of course it's got the blood stains. And then we have a sheath and a bloody sword. So the sheath has this little dangling jewelry clips. The sword is heavy duty, man. This is definitely made out of metal. All the swords are metal. And here's a bunch of them right here. The hilts look great, the handles, the dull metallic shine looks great. Some of them longer than others because they're going to stick into the base. And then here we have a mace and the front of one of her enemy's helmets. It's got blood on it, it's damaged, and this is one of their weapons. All right, then we have another bloody sword, same great quality. The blood stains, the metallic heaviness. One of Casca's right hands. So this is her wielding a blade, which is also metal. Very heavy duty, durable. Great texture on the glove, just like the other one that we saw. And she has two different positions with her swords. So this one is going to be more pointing forward, and the previous one is like holding it more downward. But same great detail on both swords. All right, and here is the arrow or the spear where the flag is going to go into and stick into the base. So very long, tough spear. All right, guys, on to the main event. So that was just that top little compartment. Removing all the tissue paper, you can see we have the body, the base, the portraits, and a lot of base elements as well. Let's start by looking at the bottom of the base. Number 122 out of 500. This is the DX or the deluxe version. He's got the same calligraphy around the base like all the Prime 1 pieces. A lot of destruction and rubble on this concrete staircase. So blood stains, enemies, weapons. Here is another left hand switch out, Casca's left hand with her helmet. So you have an option to have her with the helmet in her hand or on her head. Then we have some enemies' helmets as well. I think these are from the Blue Whale Knights. It's been a while since I read the Golden Age arc or watched the movies. We have two right arm switch outs for Casca, so you can have different directions on those swords that I showed you guys. Nice orange texture there. And we'll take a look at her body. There's a lot of good colors going on. You have her little red cape here, great texturing and shadowing here. You even have like this tatteredness to it. A lot of movement and folds in here. And the Band of the Hawk crest. Here's the big whale helmet, one of her enemies, one of the guys that she takes down as she's head of the Band of the Hawk, I believe. Blood stains, nice battle damage. And then here we have their crest. I believe this is the enemy's crest. And then you have the Band of the Hawk seal that'll go on the front. All right, another enemy helmet. A lot of good battle damage and weathering. This one's severed in half, like it was sliced in half by a sword or an axe. and then Casca's body. So she does have a spur on her left foot, same great leather texture like the gloves had, and a lot of nice little colors. Like you have those tan straps, the orange type of undergarment, her steel armor, kind of like a purple garment below the skirt. And then the portraits, wow guys, so well done. So much life in this face here. Now, I gotta be fair, man, it does lack expression. However, her pose doesn't really require her to have like an angry expression. The skin is done so well. The hair sculpted great. You have a lot of great movement there. And just, wow, really, really impressed with these portraits. The second one is essentially the same, just with the helmet. I probably won't use this switch out. I'll probably have the helmet in her hand, sculpted leather strap around her neck, great skin tones, and I like the shininess to the lips and the eyes. Before we get into the assembly, a quick shout out to the sponsor of this video, Dynamite Entertainment. Make sure you guys subscribe and hit the notification over there for all the latest announcements on The Boys, Vampirella, Red Sonja, Army of Darkness, and more. All right, so bases on the table. Let's go ahead and get the seal there. That was kind of out of order, but no big deal. We'll go ahead and key Casca in. She has a peg on her right foot. You want to get the angle right and make sure it's flush. And then we're going to start putting in all the swords. So the instructions were pretty clear this time, except for this I messed up. This is supposed to be the arrow, which I'll fix later. But anyway, yeah, it was pretty clear on where to put all the helmets and all the swords and such in the base. Here's that grill. We're going to put in another sword. We're going to put in that cross destroyed shield. That big whale helmet here, and then this axe goes like in the helmet but keys in on the base right here. On the other side we have that mace. We're gonna put in one of the bloody swords, another one of the helmets, and can't forget that tuft of feathers. Is that what you call it? Put another one of the helmets here in the back. This one is the one with the blood stains on it. And then he gets feathers as well. Over here we have another sword. A bloody sword in the back. And then this is where I realized that's the arrow that goes here. And the spear goes on the back of the base. First I got the flag on it. And then we'll key this in right here. All right, a quick look at the base, that everything's in there. What a great companion piece to Griffith, right? It has a lot of similar tones with the feathers everywhere, with the swords in the base. So it's kind of ironic how it pairs with Griffith, because this is from the Golden Age arc and Griffith is way in the future of the story. But I really like it. It's got a lot going on, a lot of Easter eggs, a lot of battle damage and blood stains. I think that fabric Band of the Hawk flag is a nice touch. You have great sculpting within the concrete and in the stairs. You see cracks and such. The sub base, like I said, just like all the other pieces, so it goes great in companions with everything. And I love that big whale or shark helmet. I think it's a whale. All right, moving up to Casca. So this is a little bit tricky. So this has almost like jewelry clamps that are supposed to go into both of those little pieces, but it's kind of hard to maneuver in there. So you know what? I just keyed it in. And we'll just leave it like that. So let's start with this first look. We got the right arm sword sticking upward. We'll go ahead and put the cape on here. Left hand holding the helmet. And we'll do that first portrait. All right, so let's take her for a spin really quick so we can just see how she looks. Yeah, I'm digging it, man. I like all the different color variations here. Casca in charge, leading the Band of the Hawk during this point. Showing her strength and her capability. I ended up putting the feather in the hat there as well, her helmet on her hand. All right, and let's go ahead and do the other arm switch out. So this one's going to have this sword pointing more downward. The only thing is you do need to take off the cape to switch out that right arm. Left hand not holding anything, and she'll be wearing the helmet here. Yeah, so this one, I like it, but I would rather have the helmet in her hand. I think it just gives her hand something to do, and it shows off her portrait better without wearing the helmet, but still a nice touch. Cape looks great flowing in the wind. She looks strong, looks powerful. Let's go ahead and get a full shot of her. All right, guys, here we go. Casca from the Golden Age arc. So this is a tragic piece to me, man. That's why I said it's so sad in the thumbnail, because she's so strong and so formidable at this point of the story. And shortly after this, she goes through a tragic event and she is never the same again. She's never like this again. And it's like, dang, to see her like this, they chose the best representation, but it just reminds you of what happens to her and how her character changes so much in the future. This piece retailed $849. Like I said, it's the DX version, which comes with the helmet portrait and the left switch out fist that's holding nothing, because it wouldn't make sense to have the helmet hand if she's wearing the helmet. Edition size of just 500 for the DX, 24 inches tall with the sword up like this. If the sword's down, her head would be the tallest point, which would make it 23 inches, and it has about an 11.5 diameter base, so obviously the depth is going to be a lot more if you have the flag like that, but you could always kind of tweak that or not even have it because it's in the back. I think it's a nice touch, though. It's kind of unique for Prime 1 to have fabric, because usually everything is 100% sculpted. The only thing I could think of is Zod in human form has kind of some mixed media elements. So, what do I think? Well, definitely gets the Gem Mint seal of approval. I think it's extremely well done. The portraits have so much life, the skin texture, the movement, the colors, and just the overall piece. Plus, it doesn't hurt that I'm a huge fan of the story. I think it's probably one of my favorite fandoms, so hard for me not to love it. Casca, I'm going to go ahead and put her in her display, so I'll leave you with her spinning on the turntable, and then I'll show you where I have her in the collection. Stay minty fresh. Peace.